हेलो। इन माय एनालिटिकल केमिस्ट्री वीडियो चैनल टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द एनालिटिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट एज स्पेक्ट्रोफोटोमीटर। नाउ इन स्पेक्ट्रोफोटोमीटर द फर्स्ट पार्ट इज रिलेटेड टू द बेसिक इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर डिस्कसिंग ऑन द बेसिक इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन पार्ट। इट इंक्लूड द इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक स्पेक्ट्रम, interaction of electromagnetic radiation with matter, then mathematical statement of derivation and derivation of photo laws like Lambert's law, Bayes' law, some terminology involved in the spectrophotometric analysis, then instrumentation part like a single beam spectrophotometer and double beam spectrophotometer. Now, a spectrophotometer is an analytical instrument used for a quantitative analysis. It measures the either transmitted, scattered or reflected light, and from that how much light get absorbed by the molecule or a molecule present in the solution, that can be calculated. That is finally the concentration of the unknown solution or concentration of the metal ions present in the solution. Now in this spectrophotometer, what happen? The light falls on the matter, then the changes takes place in the matter, but this light is you are using is in the visible range, and therefore it absorbs light. Now this absorption is related to the what type of molecules present in the solution, and remaining light get transmitted. That transmitted light measured from that how much light get absorbed, it is measured, and then from that we can calculate the concentration. Now before that, to see the instrumentation, what is electromagnetic spectrum? Now in electromagnetic spectrum, what happen? Starting from the gamma rays to AM, when gamma rays, it has a very high energy but very low wavelength. As we go from gamma rays, then X-rays, ultraviolet rays, then visible red rays, then infrared rays, radar waves, FM waves, TV waves, short waves, and AM. Now looking towards this spectrum, we are interested in the visible range. Now visible range in terms of the wavelength in nanometer, we are saying that 345 nanometer to 800 nanometer, this range is related to for the visible. Below the 345 nanometer to 200 nanometer, it is ultraviolet radiations, and above 800 nanometer, we are using the infrared radiations. Now these radiations which falls on the molecule, now in visible light, what happened? This energy get absorbed by the molecule. Now this technique we have to use for measurement of the concentration. Now in case of the electromagnetic radiation, when electric field and magnetic field is exactly perpendicular, now we know that this is the electric field, this is magnetic field. If they are exactly perpendicular, then what happened? At from this point, the radiation comes in the form of sine waves. Now when it travel from one place to another place in the form of sine or in the form of energy packets, that is the dual nature of the electromagnetic radiations. Mm-hmm. Now when we are seeing that the radiations are coming like from the emerging from this point, then one light, one radiation is giving like this, another is perpendicular, and we saw that these radiations are coming from this. Now it has some terms related to the sine wave. Now this is the one sine wave. Here the lambda is the successive distance between the two crest or two successive troughs. Now this is the wavelength. Now this can be measured like in the equation like E equal to h nu, where nu is the frequency and it is denoted by nu equal to c upon lambda, where c is the velocity of light in space and lambda is the wavelength of the light. Now these terms can be measured. Suppose from the any one of the term, we know whether it's energy is known. From that we can calculate the wavelength of the light, means properties of the light like energy, wavelength, frequency, wave number. Once you know any one, then we can find out the any other three properties with the help of these equations. Now when we observing the spectrum, now there are three types of spectrum: continuous spectrum, emission spectrum, absorption spectrum. Continuous spectrum is looking like this. There is no any gap between the two colors. This is a continuous form. This is the emission spectrum. It has a, just only the lines of the colors on the black. And in absorption spectrum, the bands are there. In between the two bands, there are the dark lines. Now in this way, continuous spectrum coming from the sun rays, the emission spectrum coming from the molecule or from the atom, and absorption spectrum, when light get absorbed from the by the molecule, then the absorption spectrum is observed. Now, interaction of the electromagnetic radiation with matter, what happened? Now we know that when light falls on the molecule, light is the energy. Now when energy falls on the molecule, certain changes takes place in the molecule. And when these changes are measured, suppose that the major changes are like this, the emission of the light. When light absorbed by the molecule, then light get emitted from the molecule. Whatever it absorbs, because the molecule, atom, absorb this light, goes to the higher energy level. It may be excited level, come back to the ground state, it emit the radiation. Absorption just means what happened? The light get absorbed and goes to the higher energy level. Transmission. Now transmission means light absorb, the remaining light get transmitted. Reflection up from the molecule or scattering from the molecule. If the atomic size is less than the wavelength of the incident light, then scattering takes place. The electron excitation may take place. When light falls on the molecule, may it has an electronic excitation takes place. Then bond vibration may be takes place. Bond breaking may be takes place. Then rearrangement in the molecule, molecule-molecule interaction takes place, or decomposition. Such a type of changes takes place, and that changes we can monitor then, and then only that principle can be used to measure the concentration of the molecule present in the solution. Now, simple photola, suppose radiations are coming from this side and it falls on the molecule, or the solution molecules are kept into the solution, in kept into the this vessel, light falls on this, the some part of the light get absorbed by the molecule, some part get reflected, some part of the light gets scattered, and some remaining part get transmitted. Therefore, photola shows that I0 is the intensity of incident light. When falls on the molecule, then some part of the light get absorbed, some part of the intensity get reflected, some part of the intensity get transmitted, and some part of the intensity get scattered. In this way, whatever the light falls on the solution, it gives in division in the four types. Now suppose intensity of incident light falls on the molecule. Now when electromagnetic radiation allowed to pass through the solution, then the light get allowed to pass through the solution. This light is called as the transmitted light. Now some of the light get passing through the solution, that is called as a transmitted light. Another light get absorbed. It's when electromagnetic radiation allowed to pass through the solution, some light get absorbed. This is called as IA, intensity of absorbed light. Now this is the light get reflected, therefore it is called as a IR, that is a reflected light. And some part of the light gets scattered in all directions. This is the denoted by IS. And therefore total light get I0 equal to IT plus IA plus IR plus IS. Now these light get some part get transmitted, absorbed, reflected, and scattered. Now this light, this photo law, we can study in terms of the Lambert's law and Beer's law. Now Lambert's law suggests that when a monochromatic beam of light is allowed to pass through the transparent medium or colored solution, the rate of decrease of intensity with the thickness of the medium is directly proportional to the intensity of the incident light. Now it is denoted in terms of minus DI by DB is proportional to incident light. That is the rate of change of with thickness. And therefore this equation can be solved in terms of the proportionality constant. Then this equation gives by taking the integration, because what happened, we are taking the small change, what happened with the solution, therefore integration is taken within the limit I0 to IT, and the thickness is related to the 0 to thickness B. Now by solving this equation, we observe that the A is equal to A into B, where A is absorbance, this is absorptivity, and B is the thickness of the solution. And therefore, according to the Lambert's law, what happened when light falls on the molecule are passing through the transparent medium, then rate of decrease of intensity of the incident light related to the thickness. And therefore, the absorption of the light is directly proportional to the thickness of the tube. The Beer's law, the second law, it is an important law related to the concentration. The similar law as a Lambert's law, where when monochromatic light falls on the molecule or solution, transparent medium, the rate of decrease of intensity with the concentration of the medium is directly proportional to the intensity of incident light. And therefore, minus dI by dC is proportional to I. When you solve this equation similar to the Lambert's law, it is observed that the total result is absorbance of the solution is directly proportional to the concentration. As the concentration increases, the absorbance of the solution is also increased because the number of molecules are increased in the vicinity of the light beam when concentration increases. In this way, the Lambert's and Beer's law, they are most important laws related to the photo laws. Now, when we combine these two laws, then it is related to the when monochromatic beam of light falls or allowed to pass through the transparent and color medium, then the rate of decrease of intensity of incident light with the thickness and concentration medium. And therefore, this law is related to the A is equal to epsilon bc, where epsilon is the molar absorptivity of the solution. It is depend on the nature of the solution. B is the thickness of the tube, and C is the concentration of the solution. Means concentration of solution and thickness, on this basis, the absorption is dependent. As thickness of the tube is increased, the absorption is increases, or concentration is increases, absorption is increases. And therefore, on the with this product, the absorption is gone, changes with change in the concentration and change in the thickness. But what happened? We are taking the same cell or cuvette with the constant thickness. And therefore, the photo law is the absorption is related to the Beer's law. And therefore, for a given system and fixed thickness, the medium, the absorption of the medium is directly proportional to the concentration of the absorbing solution. Now, in this case, what happened? A is, we are saying that A is the optical density. It is denoted by log of I0 by IT. That is the ratio, logarithm of the ratio of the intensity of incident light to the intensity of transmitted light. And from this equation, we can measure the absorbance. Suppose that we are taking the two type of solutions and we are measuring the absorbance of the first solution and absorption of the second solution. From that, we can calculate here the from the C1 concentration of one of the component with respect to the another component. Now, in case of the instrumentation of the single beam spectrophotometer. Now, this is the instrumentation part. This is the first is the mirror, second is the source. Then lens is kept to make the parallel radiation, slit is there, then filter, that is a monochromator is used here, then slit, then cuvette, and then detector is used. Now in this case, what happened? The major part as the concave mirror, then radiation source, convex lens, slit, monochromator, cuvette, or we are saying that is a cell, detector and recorder. These are the parts of the instrument. Now in this instrument, what happened? First, we are taking the blank solution. That is the one solution. And what happened when radiations are coming from this? Then these radiations are get absorbed by this. And we observe that there is a blank solution. Therefore, there is no absorption. Now in this case, what happened? When we replace this solution by the another solution, that is a colored solution, then it is observed that there is a some changes takes place in the absorption, that is a light get absorbed. Now this light get absorbed because of the colored solution, the light get absorbed by the colored pigment present in the vicinity of the light beam. And these molecules get absorbed, and therefore we observed that there is absorbance in the instrument. Now in the instrumental part, what happened? The first part is related to the source. Now what is the source? The source may be a tungsten filament, carbon arc, xenon arc lamps, then hydrogen lamp, deuterium lamp, mercury vapor lamp. These lamps can be used as a source in the spectrophotometer. But what happened? The tungsten filament, it is related to the, it used the white light. And therefore, what happened? This can be used in the colorimeter. Now, in case of the spectrophotometer, we have to, we require the intense light, beam of light. Therefore, we can use the carbon arc, carbon or xenon arc lamp. And if you require the ultraviolet radiations with the visible radiation, then we can use the hydrogen lamp, deuterated lamp, or mercury lamp for the visible ultraviolet and visible lamp. Now, in this way, from starting from 200 nanometer to 345 nanometer, it is the ultraviolet range. For this purpose, we can use the hydrogen lamp or deuterium lamp. From 345 nanometer to 800 nanometer, we can use the tungsten filament, carbon arc lamp, or mercury vapor lamp. Now, these are the lamps. This is the tungsten filament. This is the carbon and xenon arc lamp. This is the hydrogen lamp, which gives the intense the ultraviolet radiations. And this is the deuterium lamp, and this is the mercury vapor lamp. Now, these lamps can be connected to the spectrophotometer. The cost of the lamp, it affects on the cost of the instrument. The second part, it is related to the monochromator, because in the concave mirror, radiation source, concave lens, the function of the concave lens is just to make the parallel radiation. Then monochromator is the most important part, because we require the monochromatic light. Now, monochromatic light is measured, selected from the white light. There are so many type of monochromators are used. The examples are given here: the absorption filter, interference filter, prism, grating. Now, such a type of monochromator can be used as a monochromator in the spectrophotometer. Now, first is the simple filter. Now, in this filter, what happened? This is the wooden case, and in this wooden case, there is a colored plastic material or glass material is placed. Now, this absorption material has a tendency to absorb the radiations except one light, one radiation or one wavelength, and that single wavelength is allowed to transfer. Now, this is the monochromator where from the white light, all radiations get absorbed and one wavelength light is only transmitted, and that can be used as a monochromatic light. Now, in case of the another filters, monochromators, now these are the interferences filter. These are the sophisticated filters where we get the maximum intensity of the single or monochromatic light. These are the cost from this filter to interference filter. It is increases because here what happened, this type of nature of the filter is made. Here radiations are coming from this place, and they are entered into the glass material, and they reflected within these two materials. And from these two materials, whatever the light get intensity get reduced, it again add to the next beam. In this way, the intensity of the beam does not decreases. Therefore, intense light we get from the interference filter. Another filter is a monochromator is a prism. We know that the function of prism is a dispersion of the light, white light coming from this side, and it get dispersed into the all radiations. From that, we can select by using the slit any single wavelength light from the prism. Similarly, from the grating, grating also gives the number of bands of the colored bands, and that color band patch, we can select any one single wavelength from that with the help of slit, and it can be used as a variety of this radiation. Now, in case of the simple absorption filter, we get only single light. With the help of interference filter also, we get the single colored light. But with the help of prism and grating, we can take any radiation, any wavelength from 345 nanometer to 800 nanometer. But in absorption filter, it has a fixed wavelength. Interference filter has also fixed wavelength, and therefore we cannot get from these two filters any wavelength, but by using the prism and grating, we can select any monochromatic light allowed to transfer towards the cuvette. The next part is the cuvette. Now, in case of the cuvette, there are three types of cuvettes are used. First is the glass with a round bottom tube. This is a round bottom tube, and instead of that, the flat bottom tube are also utilized. It is related to the from which company we are selecting the instrument. On this basis, this we made, because cuvette size and cuvette cell is related to that instrument. Another is the rectangle or square this tube. Now, it has also the base, flat base. Sometime what happened, this is made from the glass, and sometime it is made from the quartz. the quartz gives the very high transmission rate from the material because it does not reflect or scatter the radiation due to the glass. But in glass tube, some light gets scattered or reflected. But with comparison with the blank solution, we can replace this. And therefore, no question of the which material is used for this, because we are using the transmitted light from the blank is act as a 100% transmitters or zero absorbers. And therefore, QET can be used for the instrumentation. But generally, quartz tube are used in the ultraviolet visible spectrophotometer. And this type of round bottom test tubes, glass tube or quartz tube, they are major used for the simple colorimeter. In this way, the QETs are there. In case of the next part is the detector. Now, detector in a photometer, colorimeter, spectrophotometer, the detectors are used like a phototube detector, a photovoltaic cell detector, or photomultiplier tube detector. Now, in case of the phototube detector, the function is very simple. This is the cathode and this is the anode. When radiations are coming from the solution, they are falls on the cathode and the electrons are ejected and transferred towards the anode. And therefore, it can be measured. The light intensity is measured in terms of the flow of the current, that is in terms of the voltage. As the intensity increases, the voltages will get the maximum. As intensity is less, voltage is less. In this, according to this principle, the phototube measures the intensity, and from that intensity of the transmitted light, from that how much light get absorbed, we can calculate easily with the display card, on the display card, whether absorption we have to measure or transmittance. In this way, the phototube work. It has a very low cost, and therefore it is a cheaper and it can be used in the colorimeter. Another is a photovoltaic cell. Now, in photovoltaic cell, the arrangement is like this. This is a transparent metal, then semiconductor material, and then metal plate, and it is connected to the voltmeter. Now, when radiation falls on the on the transparent medium like this, then it is heated. The semiconductor material get heated and electrons get flow from this metal to this metal. And therefore, the current flows through this circuit. Now, the flow of current is depend on how much intensity or of energy falls on the molecule, how much temperature of the semiconductor is increased. On this basis, how much electrons are flowing is dependent. Therefore, photovoltaic cell is also measured the what is the intensity of transmitted light. Another detector is a photomultiplier tube. Here, what happened? This one very simple small quantity of the photon when falls on the cathode, it reflect and transfer to the dynode. The dynode has a function to multiply the electrons, and therefore radiations get multiplied. And even that very small quantity of the photon of light from the transmitted light, it can be measured easily. And therefore, this scintillation counter or photomultiplier tube detector is used in the instrument where the cost immediately increases. Therefore, it is used in the spectrophotometer. The photovoltaic cell and phototube detector are used in the colorimeter, but it is used in this UV visible spectrophotometer. Now, this type of detectors can be used in the spectrophotometer. Now, in case of the photomultiplier tube, this is looking like this. These are the dynodes kept here. This is a cathode. When radiation falls on the cathode, immediately they are transferred and transferred into the electric pulses. And therefore, they are transferred to the recorder. In this way, these detectors are worked. Now, in case of the display card, sometime what happened, the display card is connected to the colorimeter or spectrophotometer. Sometime what happened, this spectrophotometer when connected to the computer software, then in the computer software, the graph are plotted and then they are transferred to the printer. Now here we are measuring on the display card what is the absorption takes place. Now in this way, the detector recorder works. Now in case of the instrumental part, what happened? In the single beam, we are observing that what happened initially, we observed in the instrument part. Initially, when we have to keep the blank solution, we have to start the instrument, glow the lamp, and after 15 minutes, we have to measure the transmitted light. Initially, what happened that this blank solution we have to keep. because we have to compare the solution, what are the pigments are present in the solution with respect to the blank solution. Now, first we have to keep the blank solution, and after keeping the blank solution, whatever the results are there, now these results are observed in terms of the absorbance. Now, when absorbance is there, something in colorimeter, we have to make it as a zero, because 100% transmitted light is get converted as a consider as 100%, because whatever the light get absorbed by the metal material or solvent, the reagent used for preparation of the solution, whatever the absorption is there, the transmitted light is considered as 100% light. That is the zero absorbance. After that, we have to replace this blank solution by the colored solution, and then we have to measure the absorbance. It is observed that absorbance is increased. Now, this absorbance is only due to the colored pigment present in the solution. They are also coming in the vicinity of the light beam, not from here. And therefore, this is a uniform homogeneous solution. Therefore, we can measure the concentration of the colored pigment present in the solution. In this way, we can use this instrumentation part. Now, when we are thinking about the single beam colorimeter and double beam spectrophotometer. In double beam spectrophotometer, what happened? The major change is that whatever the light coming from the monochromator is divided into two parts. One part is transferred to the from the blank solution, and another part is transferred to the colored solution or test solution. And these radiations, transmitted light, get measured. The comparison is measured by the detector, and then we observe that whatever the absorbance is there. Now, the benefit of by using the double beam spectrophotometer is that there are fluctuation in the single beam spectrophotometer, because fluctuation in the intensity of the incident light. And intensity of incident light is depend on what is the voltage we supply. And we know that in our laboratory, if we are not using the stabilizer, then the fluctuation in the voltage, and therefore we observe that there is a fluctuation in the intensity of incident light, and that's why in the fluctuation in the absorption takes place. But by using the double beam spectrophotometer, what happened? Whatever the fluctuation in the light is there, the same fluctuation in the colored solution, and therefore there is no fluctuation in the absorbance. And therefore, first is the no fluctuation in the reading, then we get the accurate reading, because whatever the comparison with the simultaneously we compare the solution. Thirdly, the minimize the change in intensity of the light. It's a change in the intensity of light. Whatever the change takes place in the intensity of the incident light, we are cancelled. And therefore, detector measures the difference between these two radiations. And therefore, it gives the accurate at the same time. Then it increases the accuracy of the analysis. And there, and it also consumes the time. And therefore, double beam spectrophotometer has applications than the single beam spectrophotometer. Now, in this way, this instrumentation part is there. Now, in this video, we just heard about the electromagnetic spectrum, what is the range of the electromagnetic spectrum, then interaction of the electromagnetic radiation with the matter, what happens, then mathematical statement related to the photo laws like Lambert's laws, Bayes law, then some terms related to the spectra, then in the spectrophotometric analysis, single beam spectrophotometer and double beam spectrophotometer. Thank you.